Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Fort Worth, Texas, also called Cowtown, the site for this game. Has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks. Alvarez fields it at the three. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line. Alvarez is the kind of guy that you want to get involved early and often, Kirk, and get the crowd in and get it behind him right now.
Absolutely. I mean, because of his big playability, you want to be able to have a chance playing at home. Get the ball in his hands. Let him make a big play or two. Just the potential of him making those big plays. This offense seems to feed off of that energy.
He guns it left side. The defender had it and then dropped it. The Horned Frogs always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down.
Mike 50.
Throw, and that one's going to hit the ground, incomplete. Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. And down he goes at the 31. Anderson picks up about 4 yards with a catch.
That'll make it fourth and six.
Howard back to return it. And he muffed it. He just couldn't pull that one in clean.
And that's what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. This was an error that should have been avoided.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And they make the stop at about the 25-yard line.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 25. Just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
They looked a little sluggish on that series. I'm curious to see if they pick things up when they get the ball back.
Bennett is waiting for the snap. And down he goes at the 45-yard line.
Decent effort. He's not the type of guy to call a fair catch very often. He does have the ability to make guys miss.
And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Around the 34-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver. Look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. Quick throw, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 25.
That brings him second and one.
Let's go!
Complete. He's got room. Knocked out of bounds around the 8-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
From the 8-yard line, it's first down. Brought down at the 8.
No gain. That brings up second and goal.
Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. Quick strike to the receiver, touchdown. To his wide receiver, who made the grab and got the score.
When this guy's got time to throw, he makes the defense pay.
They rolled the dice and went for it on fourth, and I'm sure they're happy with the result. And he hits the PAT. A 7-play, 56-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
Wilson gets set to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 26-yard line. TCU's defense looks like it's ready to feed off this crowd all game long. It's like having an extra player out there.
It sure is, Brad. They are off to a great start in that opening series. Let's see how they play here. Again, trying to just set the tone here early in this game on this next series.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He makes his way to about the 42. He's tackled right around the 50.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
The thing I love about this guy is he can throw the ball, he can run it, man, that's hard to stop.
It's on the ground, picks up the loose ball. Good hustle there by the D lineman.
It's often an overused term when referring to defensive linemen, but that's what they mean when they talk about a guy has a motor that's running. He never quit, and he played to the whistle.
They punched it in for 6 on the last series. Can they do it again?
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, and you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
And he's immediately tackled. First and 10, ball on the 44. TCU is up a score. Gets to that quickly. Sanders picks up about 3 with that catch.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Second and eight. Ball on the 41. Pressure coming. Moves up in the pocket and down he goes.
That's a loss of 6 yards. That brings up third and 14.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 34. Ground inside, and they'll bring him down behind the line. Howard, the return man. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Horned Frogs are looking downright scary on defense so far, Herbie.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
So at the end of one quarter, the Horned Frogs in front, 7-0. We're back for more action here in quarter number two. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He's taken down at about the 23-yard line. He's on the run at the 30 to the 20, and he's tackled right around the 14-yard line. First down. And he's taken down around the 12-yard line. Down, midshipman. Nobody picked up the running back on that option play.
The defense is so concerned about the quarterback's ability to create that they left the halfback all alone. And once he took the pitch, there wasn't anything between him and the goal line.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He makes the PAT. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Let's get you up to date on what's happening in Winston-Salem. We've got a tight one going on here. Western Michigan with the lead, 3-0.
Well, if that score holds up, that would be water cooler talk on Monday morning. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 21-yard line. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
Call it a loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
From their own 18-yard line, it's second down. He wants it all, going long. Can't connect.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
pushed out of bounds. Right around the 34. From their own 34-yard line. First down. Good outside run there. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. Tackle at the 36-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 36. And he has it on the corner. He gets to about the 24-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. To about the 24-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From the 24-yard line, second down.
Here we go. Green 88. Green 88.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. What a play, and that is first and goal.
You like the faith he has in his receiver to just put the ball up and let him go get it.
This is the 11th play of this drive.
Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up.
Let's go, Mike 50, Mike 50. Ready.
Touchdown, Horned Frogs.
When you're that close to the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow them into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. TCU, the kick. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Second and 9. Ball on the 26. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Pull up the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
Caught. Open field. He passes it. He's got it with room to run. And down he goes at the five. That last catch gives him 100 yards receiving.
You know, if you were to ask this defense, who wants to cover this guy, I bet you nobody's going to raise their hand because this receiver is embarrassing them.
First and goal from the four. They're knocking on the door. Touchdown, Navy. Once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
Well, this young man is having a great individual day, but some more of these guys on his team need to start doing the same if they want to get back into the game.
We'll be tied with the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Ward has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Once and all, going deep. Tackle made the 33-yard line, and it's caught. That receiver had no problem running by the secondary.
With the speed this kid has, you've got to keep him in front of you, because if he gets behind you, you're in serious trouble.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Stop it. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Steps up in the pocket. And they make the stop, the 19-yard line.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz coming.
Slings it out there incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
Second and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Anderson gained 7 yards on that play. And he's hit immediately. Pass right, running back's got it. Taken back 3 yards.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. TCU could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and it's off the upright, no good. So at the end of the half, 14 apiece.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Offensive coordinators get a lot of attention in college football these days, understandably so, and a lot of innovation going on in the sport.
Yep.
I don't know if this is innovation as much as just execution and explosive playmaking.
Yeah, and there's always a rhythm and a flow to offensive play calling, and you can see them when they start to get into it and everything just goes perfect. And right now, that's the rhythm and flow. I mean, right now, everything that they're dialing up seems to be working, and that's a special skill. It's not everybody can do it. Sometimes you get too creative and shoot yourself in the foot, but right now, passing it will, running it will, really picking good spots for both of those plays. For whether it's a run or a pass, they're picking their spots, and it's working really well.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
Very close game now as we start the second half. He's to the 20. Across the 30. And they push him out
at about the 39-yard line.
A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Chance brought down at the 30-yard line.
Call it a gain of 22 yards. First down.
Hey, they're scared. 57 is the mic. 57. Yeah, let's go. Check 26.
They'll bring him down at about the 29-yard line. Side after a nice pickup.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. Third down.
Watch number 86. Watch 86.
Come on. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 22. There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. So they're going to go for it here. As they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. He didn't get it. It's not even close. And they'll fail on fourth down.
Well, the defense looked like they were expecting option on that play. Great job to pin him up and cause the turnover on down.
Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. On the run, right side. The halfback picks up a yard. From their own 27-yard line. It's second down. Finds the junior. He's taken down around the 34-yard line. First and 10. Ball on their own 38.
Here we go. Green 9.
Alvarez was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Mike's 50. Let's go.
The Colts left finding his tailback. And they got him for a loss. Loss of three.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That brings up third and 12.
So we're looking at another third down here. Tackled back behind the line of scrimmage.
Loss of three on the way.
Wilson awaits the snap. Howard fields it at the 30, and he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. And he's taken down right around the 44-yard line. He's under pressure, and he hits him hard at the 38. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Alvarez awaiting the return. Brought down at the 36. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Tackled for a loss.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
So at the end of three, we're deadlocked right now at 14. All tied up as we head to the all-important fourth quarter. Defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 33-yard line, third down. Huge, huge play by the defense here early in the fourth quarter, and a big stop in the tie game. Wilson is the punter. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Howard fields it at the 26. He's got the corner, and he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital.
Yeah.
some room. Tackle at the 34-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Pitch out. Got the corner. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Midshipman. And he hits the PAT with a three-play, 59-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
So our score, 21-14. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five-receiver look. He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line.
Mike 50.
Here we go.
The halfback with a carry. He makes it to the 28-yard line.
No gain. That makes it third and seven.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen, and they'll get him in the backfield.
Loss of one on the play.
Wilson to punt. This one is a beauty. He's got the corner. He makes it to the 42-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
It's never good for a back's confidence to get tackled for a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it, and the holes will start to open up.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on their own 39. Midfield. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. He's at the 30, makes it out to about the 26. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. 2-yard carry by the fullback.
Yeah, there's not much room there for the ball carrier. The safety did a nice job of stepping up from the secondary and made a good stop before he could get many yards.
And down he goes, right around the 6-yard line.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
I'm not sure what happened, but one of the players is hurt. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Just over a minute left. Tackle made around the 7-yard line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
He plows ahead for a 2-yard gain. This is the eighth play of this drive. And they make the stop
right around the 8-yard line.
We had a fight to the finish here today. 21-14, Midshipman. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.